Hello everyone, first of all, thank you for being here in my YouTube channel. Please subscribe our channel for more number of electrical units. The topic is phasor representation of alternating quantities. The phasor in the sense location of alternating quantities are alternating quantities are represented in rotating line is called as phasor. Here we are going to discuss waveform equation and phasor. Waveform is this one and then equation is this one. So directly we can say. So now there is a phasor. Phasor in the sense. So just I will draw a diagram over here. Here on diagram over here. So I'll draw a circle. This is a like generator, okay? So here to here there is a one point. This is a center point. So location of alternating quantities. This is a maximum value. So is called as a phasor, right? If suppose if you want to here I1 if you want to add. So it will start here and then like this. So location of alternating quantities are alternating quantities represented in rotating line. This is a rotating line. So it's called as a phasor. Okay. So next we'll see the diagram. Here this is a one circle over here. This is a location line or alternating rotating line. It's called as a phasor. This is a phasor. This is a diagram. Just you draw a diagram and then explain. Next we'll discuss phase difference. Difference in angle. I'll take this one is voltage, this one is current. This difference will be the red. That is called as a phase difference. I'll explain once again that phasor representation. Okay. For your understanding purpose. So from here, okay. So here to here there is a one circle I'll draw, and this is a rotating line. So this is voltage, okay? Voltage start here, voltage. So here this is a current. See, so location of alternating voltages is called as phase. So this difference will be there, right? This is this is called as a phase difference. Okay, I think you understood that. So extra concepts we'll discuss now. Next is in phase. So both voltage and current are in phase with each other. See, it starts at 0 and then cuts 0 and then ends with 0. So there is no phase angle. So IM, VM are in the phase with each other. It's called as in phase. So IV is equal to VM sin omega t, I is equal to IM sin omega t. We want this one for resistive load. Okay. Next, there is a lagging phase. Current lags by voltage at an angle of phi. So current lags by voltage at an angle of phi. I told you, right, there is a waveform here to here. This one is a voltage. This one is a current. This one is current, this phase. So this is current, this is voltage. So current lags by voltage at an angle phi. We can say inductive load as an example. Okay. See here, difference will be there. Lagging phase, current lags by voltage. And so equation is V is equal to Vm sin omega t, I is equal to Im sin omega t minus phi. Next is a leading phase, current leads by voltage at an angle of phi. Similarly, see here, current leads, voltage lags at an angle of phi. So Vm sin omega t, Im sin omega t plus phi. The capacitive load is an example for this.